This is funny. This is a clip from Joe Rogan podcast, who I'm a big fan of. Everyone's trying to cancel him and Joey Diaz. And I just don't understand. Do people understand what canceling actually means and what it requires? I don't actually believe cancel culture actually exists. I think unless cancel culture only doesn't exist if you're cash rich and you have 100 to 1,000 true fans. Have those two things, you can never get cancelled. Cash rich means that you can essentially absorb any loss of sponsorship or public general public recognition and all that malarkey, right? You can withstand the blows financially from people dropping out and not sponsoring and giving any money or rescinding contracts. And of course, 100 to 1,000 true fans means that those fans more likely than not, know who you are as a person. They've absorbed so much of your content over the years. They know exactly where you stand on issues. So for the most part, they won't be surprised when scandals come out. It's not going to really catch them off guard. And they're still going to be your fans, right? You only have to look at somebody like Louis C.K. Of course, in the interim, he did lose a lot of money. I think he said, he estimated something like 30 million, Louis C.K., right? He had a movie that was meant to come out that kind of didn't get a big theatrical release. He had a Netflix deal that went south. Like, loads of things got pulled out underneath the rug from him, right? But he was able to withstand the blows of cancel culture because, number one, he was cash rich. He had a lot of money that he could kind of survive by not working. And, of course, he had 100 to 1,000 true fans who essentially, downloaded his stand-up comedy special that he put on the website just a few months ago. So sometimes I think people, these cancel culture thing, don't get it. Like, Joe Rogan's one of the most successful podcasters in the world, if not the most successful podcast in the world. He just recently signed a 200 million Spotify deal. If that's a marker of how much cash he has, he probably was estimated to make like 30 mil or something a year from podcasting alone, is what we know of, not considering all of his other businesses that he's involved in, right? On it, his work he does for the UFC, I'm not sure if he still does it for free, but regardless, right? Like, this guy's got his finger in a lot of pies. So to assume that you could cancel him for saying some racy jokes on his podcast after all these years, you just don't know how cancel culture really how to really cancel somebody. You guys don't have no idea. Anyway, I thought this was interesting because this is a really funny debate that he had between Bill Burr, one of my favorite comedians, and Joe Rogan, where Joe Rogan essentially has that weird stance around masks that a lot of people have in the States. It's not really prevalent in the UK, in the Europe. I feel as if people that are not wearing masks in Europe or in London for the most part just decide not to wear it. I don't think they have this idea that it's a kind of a pussy thing or if it's a scare tactic. I don't think so. Maybe I haven't spoken to anyone that doesn't wear a mask, don't get me wrong. I've not had long conversation with anybody this whole lockdown, but I would assume most people that don't wear masks are just like willing to take the risk, right? Because we all have the internet, we all have access to Twitter and social media. We'll have the same access to the same information. So you just have to make a concentrated effort for yourself and your family to say, look, hey, if I decide to wear a mask, I do. If I don't, I don't. But in America, they have this weird split where it's obviously a political debate. It's like blue v red when it comes to masks. And it's also macho v non-macho. It's like a thing of like, oh, if you don't wear a mask, you're obviously a man. And if you don't wear one, you're not. And it's like, odd. And this clip is a good example of it, right? This is from the Joe Rogan podcast. I'm going to play it here. Actually, I'll keep it off the screen so I don't get sniped.
The whole thing is, it's just fucking creepy to have guys like Mayor Garcetti be in charge of telling people whether or not they get to work. Like, that's not what a governor is supposed to be. That's not what a mayor's supposed to be.
They're trying to look out for your best interests and trying to get 400 million people to all pull in the same direction. It's you can't get 40 comics to pull in the same direction. So
they
like
did.
They have like an impossible. Well, they did and they didn't. There was people fucking right the whole fucking time. There's been fucking assholes on my street walking around no masks.
And that's the issue, isn't it? Because there wasn't a I guess that's why I have a problem with all this, with people that are unwilling to had the debate around, oh, why did New Zealand do such a good job? They're like, oh, we can't compare them to different countries because, they have a smaller population, it's an isolated country, the politics are different. Blah, blah, blah. No, let's have a conversation about why did some countries handle coronavirus very well and some countries didn't. Part of the issue is just compliance, right? Some people just, unfortunately, for the most part, maybe America is a really good example of it because there's so many conspiracy theory nuts out there anyway. If you have a whole country full of parents who generally believe in anti-vax and think, vaccines give their kid autism, it's no surprise that these same people are also going to be shouting and screaming when somebody at Walmart tells them they can't enter if they don't wear a mask. It's no real surprise, really. But that's a conversation you should be having in public. Like, what maybe we need to change the public conversation, the public sentiment around science. And it's not an exact science, but obviously it does provide some level, some framework, right? If you have a headache, you take an aspirin because it generally does work. To suggest otherwise is really asinine. But again, what do I know?
You know, not quarantining like the people that come by the houses. You see the fucking, you know, the same people that were going in and out of the house who are not part of their family still going in and out of the house.
You want people to walk down the street with a mask on?
Let's not start this, Joe.
Do you, though?
Let's not start this. Okay.
Let's start it.
I don't want to start this bullshit. I'm not going to.
And it's funny that Joe asks that. Do you want people to walk down the streets? No, I want people. It's obviously, and again, this is the thing that's really bizarre, about, especially in the States. The people that want the economy to reopen and reopen the economy, let's get started. We can't live in fear. Go outside. I don't understand why they're so against masks. Like, if the only requirement that you have to go outside, imagine if every government in the world said, okay, lockdown's over, go outside and enjoy yourself, celebrate like it's 1999, right? And they only require you to wear a face mask and to make sure you social distance, or to make sure when you meet people, they're only your close group of friends, whatever it may be. Is that so much to ask for, really? For to get back to some semblance of normality? Do people honestly think it's a good idea for us just to all go out en masse without any kind of social, without any kind of protocols when it comes to hygiene and social distancing? Do you think that's honestly a good idea? Like, legitimately, with the virus still lingering? Or do people actually believe this whole, like, Trump rhetoric about it just washing away? It's not going to wash away, right? It's not. That's not how viruses work, bro, friend. Have you not watched a movie lately?
I'm going to sit here with no medical degree, listening to you with no medical degree, with an American flag behind you, smoking a cigar, acting like we know what's up better than the CDC. All I do is I watch the news once every 2 weeks. Exactly. I'm like, mask or no mask? Still mask? All right, mask. That's all I give a fuck about. I don't
care. That's the thing. That's the same thing I do. I don't understand why. And I guess that's why I'm really happy that some shops have reopened. I generally think people just need to. The vast majority of the population, myself included, I'm a fucking, you know, idiot. I don't know jack shit, right? I just barely graduated from university. I don't know whatever I'm talking about. The vast majority of us shouldn't be having debates about whether or not masks are essential to wear in public where the coronavirus lingering. We're not virologists, right? We have no right in this conversation. We should be sitting there silently nodding when intellectuals are speaking in the room. We have no right to say our opinion, to give our thoughts, or if we do have a right to say it, we shouldn't be expecting people to listen to us because we don't know what the fuck we're talking about. What we should be doing is checking in every week or so and hearing what the experts say, analyzing things for us, to like seeing here what experts say, this, you know, analyzing what it is with your situation, who you live with, where you go, blah, 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 and then making an informed decision like we always do, right? That's what you do in your day-to-day life. Right, you get given some guidelines by the government about certain things, and then you look at what you do with your own life, and you come to a really adult, grown-up conclusion. But you don't sit there ruminating and trying to convince yourself about what's wrong and pointing out all these things. That's a waste of time. Waste, because that's not your business. You should spend your time doing the things that you're really good at, right? Whether it's pouring pints in a pub or delivering mail, whatever it is, that's what you should be spending your time on, not worrying about, you know, whether you should wear a mask or not. If they say wear a mask, you wear it. When they say don't wear it, you just take it off. No big deal.
Care.
But even they say you shouldn't wear a mask unless you're treating a coronavirus patient. The World Health Organization.
Yeah, but they didn't say that initially. They didn't say it initially.
No, they didn't.
They did. And then it gradually, and then everybody wore the fucking masks. This is like rollerblading. Everybody fucking rollerbladed, and then there was that one fucking homophobic joke, and then everybody acted like they never did it. And then 100 million fucking rollerblades got thrown into the fucking ocean. We all wore masks. And then all of a sudden,
exactly.
People are fucking sitting there. What? You don't have the body type for it, dude. Your fucking knuckles would scrape on the ground. Even with that extra 2 inches. I just love how wearing a mask became like this fucking, like, soft thing that you were doing. Like, yeah, being courteous. Being courteous. What is it for bitches? That was so stupid.
You're wearing a mask. First of all,
oh, God, you're so tough with your fucking open nose and throat. Joe, and your 5 o'clock shadow. This is a man right here. A man doesn't wear a mask. Why does it always become like that? It's always...
Bilbo's the best, isn't it? That's a great encapsulation of that incident. And again, I just don't understand it, man. Like, it's mostly a US thing. It's not. We don't really have it here in the UK. I don't think so. I think most people that are not wearing masks are just like, you know what? I'm just not going to wear it. But it's a very bizarre thing, isn't it? That's a weird hill to die on. Especially because, you know, it could legitimately lead to your death. It's like, But hey, what do I know?